This is Dr. Contreras, and we are here at SAPS, also known as the Society for Acute Paranormal Studies. I have a subject with me today, Micah D, subject number 1838.05, who has been dealing with some very odd, strange paranormal activity going on in his home with his wife, Danielle. Micah, thank you for coming to the office today.
No problem.
As you can see, I've set up a camera to record everything as a documentation to figure out, as a scientist and investigating on some very interesting things that have been happening with your wife.
Weird stuff, yeah.
All right, so I have got this camera so I can start filming, around the house, me and my wife, Danielle. So we can try to maybe catch some kind of paranormal or supernatural or, you know, ghost activity, kind of like a, you know, ghost hunters of the, you know, Micah's house type situation. I think that, you know, what happened was apparently when my wife was younger, she was attacked by spirits, and I think that they've continued to kind of plague her to this day. And if we can catch something on tape, then maybe that can help us then get rid of those spirits. Maybe take it to some kind of professional or, you know, some kind of, you know, somebody who would know what to do. You know, they'd be like, oh, I know that kind of spirit situation. We can do this, you know, remedy to get rid of that spirit. And then, you know, oh, and here she is.
What are you doing?
All right. What I want to do is start filming us, like, throughout the day and throughout the night, and try to catch some paranormal activity, some ghost activity, on tape.
Are you crazy? Well, why do you want to do that?
Because, like you said, I mean, when you were younger, I mean, I think that you're still being plagued with spirits from your past.
Baby, what makes you think I was plagued by spirits from my past?
You said that when you were younger, when you were a kid, that when you were a teenager, you were attacked by spooks, and I think that that energy, that spirit energy, is still affecting you.
Babe, I said I was attacked by spooks, and I meant black men, not ghosts.
What?
Baby, really? Did you really think that
spooks?
Spooks is also like a derogatory term for African American men.
I thought that
men,
you meant
honey.
Like ghosts and like spirits
no.
and things. I thought you meant.
Really?
What?
Micah.
I'm confused.
Come on.
So you're just. Alright, I guess I misunderstood this story.
A little bit, I think so.
Well, but nonetheless, I mean, you have to admit some weird stuff's been going on around the house. I mean, like noises and like smells.
A
and,
little.
Like, you know, stuff going. You know.
So you want to experiment on me and this house?
Not just you, us. I mean, it's us. We're trying to figure out what's going on here. I mean, I think that we might be onto something.
Okay.
Maybe make some money through this or something, or like figure out, you know, if there is a spirit affecting you or me or like the house in general. Then if we took care of that, maybe, you know, it could like improve the energy of the house and like make everything
Whatever.
Better.
You're crazy.
I think it could be fun. It's your tape and
I have another idea how we could use the camera and it could be fun.
Well, later, but
can you explain to me then that you're seeing ghosts?
Yes.
Spirits?
Yes. Hearing, seeing, smelling, everything. It happened pretty much when he got the camera. That's when it started really coming up. And I was like, wow. There is some really crazy stuff going on in this house, targeted at me. And it's scary, and I want my husband to protect me, and that's what he's been doing. He's been protecting me.
You and your husband, where'd you meet at?
Well, I was working at a local bar, and he came in for some drinks, and he was cute, because he's got that geeky type of look to him.
Yeah, a little dork look.
Yeah, and I'm not usually attracted to that, but he was a sweetheart, and I always go for the bad guy, so I kind of went a different route and went for the good guy, and he tipped me well. So I went on a date with him, and then the rest is history. Okay, so if you're going to film me, I want to make sure that you get me looking good.
What?
Where is this going to, by the way? Is it just for us to
this
look
is
at?
For us, and if we find something, we'll take it to some kind of professional or something.
Is there a way that I could look at myself while you film me?
No.
Can I rewind it and watch the feedback?
Yeah, we have to watch it. Oh. We have to, like, watch it later and see if there's anything going on in the background.
But baby, I don't want to know what's going on in the background.
But if we have spirits in our house, you don't want to know.
Yeah, but baby, we don't have spirits in our house.
But you gotta admit, some weird stuff.
That's you, sometimes. Honey. You're just a little bit on the coward side, but I don't say anything. I love you.
I'm not a coward. I think that there's stuff.
Where's that?
I see. Boom. I put it on the tripod.
Yeah.
Put it on the tripod.
Yeah.
Now we can just sit here and we can just do whatever we want, and it's filming, and catching on what's going on that we're not seeing, because I think things are going on.
What things are? Baby, did you see the doorbell ring?
This is a perfect example.
It's the doorbell.
Now we have that sound on the tape. Doorbell ringing for no reason.
No,
I'm not expecting anybody. There's nobody at the door. Who are we expecting right now? Exactly right. There's nobody at the door.
You're setting me up. That's what you're doing right now, right? All right. Did you pay the guy next?
There's nobody. I didn't pay anybody. Okay, let's go look for some people. Do you see any people?
No.
Do you see anybody out there?
No.
Let's find the people.
Do you have a string on the door?
I got nothing on the door, honey.
Are you trying to set me up?
I'm not trying to set you up. I think that this is a sign that the spirits know I'm right. The spirits are responding.
Oh, you're a genius now? So the spirits are going along with your genius idea to scare the living shit out of me?
I don't know.
What do you mean you
don't
know?
I want you on board with this. Tell me you're on board.
On board.
There was an incident that happened where you had a doorbell ring. Can you explain to me about, I noticed in the camera it was showing a delivery package or something at your door. Can you explain why you guys freaked out about that?
There was a delivery package?
Yes, there was. There was a doorbell ring, according to one of your footages, to go answer, no one was there.
Yeah, exactly, there was no one there. That was what was so terrifying, is that the doorbell rings, you go to the door, you expect somebody to be there or something, and
do you always expect somebody to be there, Mr. Micah D?
Usually I don't see why it would be ringing otherwise. If the doorbell rings, it means somebody's there. And if somebody's not there, then what rung the doorbell?
Baby, you're trying to set me up.
I'm not trying to set you up.
Yes, you are.
Hand to God, hand to my heart. I had nothing to do with that doorbell. That is,
so the spirit is clearly, it just rings, like?
Clearly the spirits want the camera on. They want to communicate.
They don't like that though. It's the complete opposite. They wanted us to leave them alone.
We don't know that.
You know, I told him once he brought the camera in, stuff would really start happening, because they don't like that. The spirits, they don't like that. Anything that has to do with them bringing them out, they get pissed off. And they got pissed off that day, Doc. Big time. Okay, nothing's going on, then you leave them, you bring a camera out and the doorbell rings.
Well, you say nothing's going on. I think some weird things have been going on.
Like what?
Well, I mean, we've had situations where, like, there were noises in the house that we couldn't really explain, things like that.
Mm-hmm.
You mentioned something about the water once, just going back and forth.
Mm, that's weird.
You know, we had stuff with that.
Yeah, you're right.
I mean, there are things that have been happening in the house that we just, and I have this hunch that there's some kind of energy, and maybe that's them putting that hunch in my brain, like,
really?
While I'm sleeping. But now that we're getting this confirmation.
That scares me, though.
We're getting this confirmation from the spirits that they're, they're ringing the doorbell. Clearly, our doorbell's not broken. We know that. What are you smoking? I just washed a shirt.
I don't know, it smells
in
here.
It's not me.
You smell that?
You smell smoke? I smell smoke.
Yeah, like really, really bad smoke. Like something's burning. It's on fire.
You cooking anything right now?
Babe.
Well, I mean, I'm not cooking anything right now. Why is it smelling smoke? Confirmation number two. That's it. Number two. We got the doorbell. Now we got the smoke. That's two senses. That's sound. And now we got smell. They are communicating with us, telling us that they want this camera on.
Stop talking about it with me and go look to see where it's coming from.
Well, I think this is definitely the spirits. This is definitely the spirits.
It smells so bad.
Spirits smell like smoke. Spirits smell like smoke. I read that somewhere.
Where did you read that?
I don't remember.
Burning smell throughout the house.
Another freaky one.
Really?
Another freaky one. I mean, what can that be a sign of? Your whole house just suddenly smells like something's burning. Nothing, but we checked the stove. We checked the oven, the microwave, the heaters, we checked the basement, we checked the attic, everything, nothing was on fire.
You checked the gas.
Yeah, we checked our gas, we went outside the house, checked everything, nothing is burning, and you have this smell of smoke all throughout the house.
Hmm.
I mean, people see ghosts sometimes, and so you have that visual thing, we didn't ever see anything, but other people
what is to say that a spirit can't communicate via smells? And a burning smell is a little bit threatening, thus the cause for my concern.
Did this burning smell come from a certain location of the house?
I mean, it kind of started in one room and then kind of moved throughout the house. So obviously, you know, that room we checked first for anything burning, so anything...
Do you recall the days that when it happened that it might have been windy outside, Mr.?
I don't know about windy. It was usually on the weekend, though. It was usually like Saturday afternoons that we get it.
Woo! Yeah, that's on fire. That's on fire.
God.
There were a few things that my investigators and I took. You allowed us to go into your home, and you allowed us to investigate and look at things, and then trying to compare with some of the footage of some of these strange things that were happening. And,
right.
and one of them was that your power went out.
Yeah.
Can you explain to me? Do you remember what happened that
day? You know what, Doc? I can't even explain it to you.
All right, so we are sitting down for a moment. We're going to watch some TV before bed. We got the game on right now. My lovely wife has let us sit and watch some sports.
No, I didn't.
But we're just going to watch for a little while.
We did watch already.
But this is a different game.
Yeah, it's the first quarter of the game.
I know, but... What?
Oh.
Did you... How did... What's, That's funny. That's real funny. Did you do this?
No, I didn't do it.
How do you shut off all the lights in the house in the one time?
I don't know.
Maybe I'll have magical powers.
I don't know.
No. That's it. This is number three. It is the spirits are pissed off. The spirits are pissed off.
Why
that we are not taking them seriously enough. You are not taking them seriously enough.
What do you want me to do? A dance? A jig? What do you want me to do?
I want you to acknowledge their presence. They can tell. Even if you say, like, oh, I believe you. If you don't actually believe it, they know.
Oh, like inner soul feelings? They want to know that I really, truly...
It's a spirit being. It only has inner soul.
What do
you
want me to do?
I want you to start... If this isn't proof enough, I don't know what is.
Okay, Michael, what do you want me to do?
I want you to really believe that something's going on here. I want you to be 100% on board with this. We gotta figure this out.
All right,
we can't be dealing with this stuff for the rest of our lives.
Let me get this. DS spirits, I believe that you are in my house, and I believe that you are trying to reach out to us. Amen.
Do you believe that?
Yes, wholeheartedly.
Then hopefully we'll be able to watch some TV later, and they won't just shut off the power every 2 minutes.
Yes, and I hope it's the sports channel again. I really do, sweetheart.
I don't believe you.
Yeah, that one freaked me out. Didn't like that.
What was so freaky about your
power? Well, I mean, that means that the spirits at that point had control of the entire house. I mean, or their presence was so strong that it just obliterated the power in the house. I mean, think about that. I mean, you have situations where maybe a spirit causes a slight, you know, gust of wind or something. That's disconcerting. But when a spirit presence is so powerful that it just, boom, knocks out your electricity, I mean, would you not be concerned to have a presence, a paranormal presence of that strength in your home? I mean, that one was scary.
Okay, we are now going to find the power box.
This is
try
freaky.
To undo what these spirits did to our power. Hopefully nothing's permanent. A little scary. The spirit's trying to freak us out. Get that. What is that? I that was not there earlier today. What is that?
I don't know.
What is that?
I don't know.
Honey, what is this? What is this? What are these? They're pictures. They're pictures. What are they? Pictures. Pictures of spirits. Pictures of spirit. Not.
Oh.
That. Why does that look like you?
Oh my god.
Honey, why does that look like you?
I have no idea.
Honey,
Micah.
That is definitely you.
Micah, that is exactly not like me. Micah, that is not me. That's sick.
These photos in a hallway.
Yeah.
Of guys. You possibly partying?
No.
You ever black out?
No. I have photos in my hallway of my wedding.
Your wedding?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. With me and Mike on vacation. Is that what you're referring to?
Are you in love with your husband?
Yes. With every inch of my heart.
You are.
Mm-hmm. It's the spirits.
I mean, the spirits...
I've never did that before in my life. I swear to God, baby. I've never done that.
Where would those come from?
They made them up. Look, that doesn't look like me. I don't have bangs.
That.
Okay, and that's like a triple-sized arm. That's not me.
That's just that, honey. That's you.
That's not
you. That's
me.
You. Look at the face. Look at the face.
That's not me.
That's just
me.
The camera angle. That's just the camera angle. That is not face. Same thing.
That is not
same,
me.
Same face.
That's the spirits. Are you kidding me right now?
You're I want to know why there's pictures of you in these
it's
pictures.
Of what you
Who is
saying.
This guy? Who is this guy? When were you at a party
oh
with all these
God,
years?
Oh my God! I can't believe you don't even believe me right now. This is making me very upset. Extremely upset right now. It's your ghost stories that you keep talking about, and now you're attacking me. I'm the victim right now, not you. Okay?
No.
It's your fault. You're making me cry right now.
I want to know what's going on.
It's
I'm confused.
Not me.
I'm confused.
Do
I'm
you
just
think
confused.
I would do that? I would never do
I
that.
I don't think you would do that. I don't think you would do that ever. I'm sorry. I'm just confused. I'm confused. The spirits
cry,
are upsetting
Micah.
Me. I'm sorry.
Is this just a one-time incident that your power went out?
This was just one time. This was a one-time thing, which I think is a sign that possibly the spirits are getting stronger. That it's just happened, that it hasn't happened in the past.
Have you taken the time to review all the footage that you've given me?
No. We watched a lot of it. But you know, there's hours and hours and hours. So you know, sometimes I start watching it, and then kind of like put it in fast forward, and just kind of like watch it, and then I don't know. Sometimes like get distracted. And,
what was that?
Micah, get this.
What was it? I saw something.
Idea.
I saw something.
I saw it too. I saw it too. It's right over there.
Do you see it?
Yeah, it's right over there.
What is it?
I don't know. It's black. I can't really make it out.
What is it? Is it still moving?
Holy shit.
What is it?
I don't know what that is. Oh my God, baby. That's
This is not cool. We got stuff surrounding our house.
Wait. Oh, yeah.
You see it?
It's a cat, Micah.
Like just a regular cat?
Yeah, a black cat.
Oh.
Ooh.
Oops.
You cried like a little baby. What are you doing?
Fast forwarding through the tape from the other night in the bedroom. Try to find something.
Why?
Something might have happened.
Nothing happened. You were there.
Something. We were asleep. We wouldn't know.
Yeah, but I don't remember anything happening. I was sleeping.
Something, a very small thing could have happened.
Oh, this is so boring, oh my God.
Any piece of evidence we can put together is good.
What do you have, like a full investigation going on?
Yes, we have to investigate the spirits and the energies and the...
How long have you been doing this for?
30 minutes.
Did you bring the garbage out?
No, this is more important than the garbage.
Really? Because it's stinking up my entire kitchen right now. I smell it from here, actually.
When I ask
you to do something, I expect you to do it, Micah. Instead of playing around with your little toys.
It's not a toy, it's a TV.
I would hear it. Go take out the freaking garbage, Micah. Enough now. Seriously, I asked you 10 minutes ago. God.
With you hiring a spiritual woman that by the name of Butterfly.
Yeah, kind of a weird name, but she came and she tried to come help us. I think she did, to some extent, help us kind of understand what was going on.
I did not like her. I did not care for her one bit. In fact, she came in my home and tried to bamboozle myself and my husband. Baby, now what are you doing?
Oh, okay. I didn't tell you before because I wasn't sure how you would feel about it, but I hired a spiritual advisor for us. She's on her way now.
Why?
I think that she may be able to help us, be able to shed some light on what's been going on with the spirits and maybe
figure
out...
What does she do? What?
I don't know exactly.
Where'd you find her?
Phone book? Yellow Pages?
found a spiritual person in the yellow
You can
pages
find anything in the yellow
to come
pages
into my house.
I think that what she's going to do is come in and maybe figure out why the spirits are here.
How much does she want from you?
She said that we would discuss that after the fact. I don't know, but I think you can't put a price on our happiness, on our safety, and if there is a spirit in our house making us un... She's here now. All right.
I like the gel you put in your hair.
Hello.
Hello.
Butterfly,
there.
I presume.
Are you Micah?
I am indeed.
Hi, Micah.
Nice to meet you.
Pleasure.
Please come in. It's my lovely wife, Danielle.
Danielle.
Holy shit. Hi, Danielle. Oh my God. I can feel the energy of this nasty. This is what we're talking about.
Yeah, the spirit.
Nasty.
Yeah.
You have. I feel a few of them in here, actually.
Oh boy.
There's a few disgusting. Let's see, I'm getting one that's about 16 years old at death.
Oh my.
Who is haunting you.
Okay.
And I'm feeling one over here.
Yeah.
Right there in the piano, and so you probably hear the piano sometimes, right? Because it never really. Okay.
Maybe we just haven't heard it. Maybe it's when we're not around. Maybe it's while we're asleep or something. We just haven't heard it. It's a quieter piano.
There is one about 25, and I feel one that's 60. So
okay.
You have three of them.
Three
yeah,
spirits.
We have a family in our house, honey.
Three spirits. No, well, that's...
A family of dead people. I had no use for her as a person, as an individual, as a woman. All of the above. I did not care for her. She caught an attitude way too quick for my liking.
Are you practicing any, are you doing anything to help yourself?
We don't really know where to start. That's what we would love to hear from you.
Yeah, that's why he hired you.
Are you doing any special prayer? Are you calling on Archangel Michael? Archangel Michael is sitting right here next to you.
That's our Christmas tree topper, but Micah hasn't put it in the attic yet.
Yes, hello, Michael.
Sorry, that's Micah. That's the Christmas tree
type. Yeah,
I don't understand.
Well, Archangel Michael has been trying to protect you, okay?
That's
and
good.
You also have two other little totems, angel totems,
mm-hmm.
Okay? You have...
Those were a gift from my aunt.
Raphael.
They're gnomes. Nomads, actually, right?
Well, she does, maybe she doesn't know that my aunt didn't know what she was buying.
Mm-hmm. Well, these have been trying to protect you, but it's not working because the dark forces are so strong.
They're so...
I mean, it's going to take some serious black magic miracle dances to get, some of this cleared out.
What are we doing?
This is the traditional gypsy butterfly dance.
Okay.
And it is my international Ghostbuster spell to send the gremlins away! Away!
She's
going
to
hit my hands. She's getting into it. Music.
That one's
okay. Before they start taking me over, hit it!
Don't scratch the floor up. Okay. Free. Mika, you're going to buff it. I'm not gonna move in my own house. It's my kitchen. I don't have to move out
of law
to. She's more than enough
room
to
parody. She's gonna work. It's gonna work.
Yeah!
You dropped it.
I feel it! You're gone!
Do you get along with Butterfly? I get
along okay with, I, you know, oh, it's all right.
You don't think she's strange?
She's a little odd. She's a little different. But, I mean, what would you expect from somebody in that situation? Somebody who, I mean, their job is to deal with, you know, crossing a past, paranormal, these things, I mean, they would, over time, make somebody kind of
so you believe
take
your
a different
wife
path.
That these things were happening, and you believe Butterfly stating the things that have been going through between your wife and you that's been happening in this house.
Yeah, so like I said, she was able to lend explanations that seemed to make some sense. More or less. I think she, you know, she knew what was going on. She's a professional.
Danielle, I need you to sit down for me, and I'm going to have to do a clearing here with you.
Yes.
Because
good.
Has she been acting strange at all, Micah?
A little different than in the past. You know that, honey. You've been a little bit more on edge, mm-hmm. Recently. But yeah. But I'm pretty sure that's the spirits. I think it's all connected.
Okay.
Maybe.
So,
yeah.
Okay, dear one, let's have a seat, and we're going to call upon your team of angels and spirit guides.
All right.
And we're going to do a spiritual clearing and purification. I have some of my magical white powder here, and this white powder is going to help you release some of those nasty gremlins, those little demons that are, they're taking over your whole house. Your whole house is haunted, okay?
Oh,
for heavens to Betsy, it's haunted. And you've got just nastiness following you everywhere. I mean, honestly, in the sink, in the toilet, in the shower, I mean, you can't wash them away. So, Danielle, I'm going to go ahead and ask you to take a couple deep breaths. Okay, don't be fearful at all. Have no fear. You have Archangel over there with you here. And we're going to purify you, dear.
No, it's fine.
Are you kidding me? Micah, they don't like that because that provokes them to do mean and horrible things. And she provoked them to come and attack me and my husband.
She's purifying
you.
Are you kidding me,
Micah?
It's part of the process. It's part of the process.
Micah,
okay, I think she's purifying.
Are you kidding me, Micah?
It's part of the process. This is part of the process, right?
It's a necessary part of the process.
What are you, what goes through your head?
Have you ever seen magic powder before? What do you know what it looks like?
Out of my account?
How do you know if it's working or not? It could be working right now. It could be gone spirits already.
Can you get him the hell out?
This is a start, you know. It's really a start.
No more. Do whatever you gotta do, just don't throw a powder in my face. Please, not my house.
Would you like that, or we can do an exorcism?
An exorcism?
Yeah.
I'm not, I don't have demons in me.
I think she would need an exorcism. She can sense it.
Did you watch The Exorcist? The broad's head spins around and speaks out
that
the vile Micah.
That was fictional.
We're gonna have a talk. Apparently, we're learning a lot now that we have a whole dead family in our house. I didn't know. Good job, honey. At least
they
success after
well,
all.
Well, I think that would be something good to know. We were
right.
Ignorant of it before. What's she doing?
I can feel them. They're coming in right now.
They know that they
are going to do everything they can to keep you.
He's Jewish, by the way. He doesn't really believe in
any
of this stuff.
Behavior.
I think,
okay.
You know, you go to a doctor to tell you that you're sick. You go to a carpenter to fix your house. You go to a spiritual advisor to tell you if you have demons in your house.
Go get your yarmulke and put it on. See how crazy they get now.
How long have you lived in this haunted house, for God's sakes?
A year.
Okay. Well, these spirits have been here for many, many lifetimes. Thousands of lifetimes, okay?
I think the house is only 15 years old, though.
Explain to me about Butterfly's aura.
That was a cause for a little bit of tension, which was unfortunate right off the bat, between Danielle and Butterfly. Butterfly came in and immediately confronted Danielle and, for lack of a better word, accused her of having what she deemed a brown aura. What are we doing now? What is next?
Well, let me just explain a few things to you here. I've got my Wheel of Fortune, my auric color wheel here with many of the definitions to, you know, bring you up to speed here.
Right.
We've got.
We're gonna figure out what Danielle's aura is.
Yes.
What color? Okay.
Yes, I can tell you right now that when Danielle came into this lifetime, when she was just a newborn baby incarnating into the world on her birth date, she was a beautiful violet, the violet flame of Saint Germain, pure white light coming down, angelic light, okay? And since then, unfortunately, I have to tell you the bad news now, she has digressed to a shit bark brown.
Excuse me?
Nasty. Nasty brown.
How can you change that much? How does that... Is that the demon?
Is
the demon
bark
doing that?
Brown on your Wheel of Fortune?
What the hell is shit bark brown,
Micah?
I don't know. I think... It's the demon would be doing that, correct?
She's calling me shitty, Micah.
If she were...
In my own damn house.
Possessed partly or something, it would affect the aura, right?
That's right. Micah,
okay,
you're exactly right.
She's not saying you have a shitty brown aura. It's the demon.
That's what she just said.
The demon has a shitty brown aura.
I'm going to black and blue her eye up in 2 seconds
no,
and take
no,
one shot
no,
and shove
no,
it right up.
You
don't wear, Micah.
When these...
She's attacking me.
She's not attacking me. She's verbally
and now mentally attacking me.
She's talking about the demon,
really?
Not about you.
Really?
She's just talking about the demon.
I have a demon in me, butterfly. Is that
you
what it
have
is?
The demons that are in you right now, at least one or two of them. I don't know. I'm still spirit testing, to see if all three of them have possessed you. But if I can't shake a dance for you to release these spirit ghosts to go back into the light.
I really have no idea what she's saying now.
I
have no idea what she's saying.
She's trying to get the spirits out of you. She's going to
get
you
that
purple aura.
What language
you want
that purple
aura, right? Yay.
What is she? What language is she?
The violet.
I like black, Micah. Okay, I don't even like a freaking color. I like black. I wear black. That's what I like. Give me black.
I don't
that's
know if
very
that's a good aura, though. Is that a good aura? Black?
I don't care what it means. I look good in black. My legs look good in black. My ass looks tight. That's what I like. Shit brown doesn't do it for me, Micah. And now she's talking a language that I don't understand, and she's attacking me. She's attacking your wife. What are you going to do about it?
She's not attacking you. She's attacking the demons.
Seriously, lady? This is gross.
Okay, we need to take a quick break. I think we're just going to... Just a quick... No. Just go...
I swear to God,
Go get your glass of water.
I want to talk to you.
Okay.
Do you believe maybe she might be lying to you and your husband?
Who, Butterfly?
Yes. Who did you think else I would think was lying?
I just don't like Butterfly. If she was lying to my husband, I couldn't really tell you. She probably is. I don't know. Okay, let me show you this. I turn the water on sometimes, and it goes from cold to really hot. I don't touch the faucet at all. It'll just change on its own, out of nowhere. It's really actually weird, because I don't touch it. Let me see. Wow, see? It's hot. It's hot now.
Yeah, I can already feel it. I don't even need to touch it. It's quite normal, Danielle, when you have these spirits.
What's going on?
Your spirits, your nasty gremlins have taken over. They're in your water. I mean, it's normal, okay, Micah? It's normal.
Is it dangerous for her? I drink that water? Is that going to be a problem?
It could show up. It could show up in your chemistry
Maybe that's what's affecting your aura, is from drinking the water.
That's probably it, maybe.
Okay. Right, we don't want to have any cancer or anything nasty like that in your blood system. So I'm going to invoke Archangel Michael to cut through this water, and we are going to chop right through it with his sword. I invoke Archangel Michael and his power now.
Did it work?
It's going to be a few moments to let the dust settle.
sorry, Daddy.
Yeah, no, I'm sorry. I'm listening. Look at my set, Patrick.
Does that mean it worked?
Were
you in good shape?
Well, I'm not sure. It's a kind of... It's a bad water. I'm losing my balance here. Do you want me to shut it off? Please shut it off right now. It might take 24 hours. Because we have downloaded Archangel Michael.
Downloaded? Okay.
Yeah. We are downloaded in our sleep.
Oh,
okay.
Okay.
So... at this point, Butterfly is showing us how to apply a trapping powder to the ground, which hopefully is going to trap them. We have to do it in a line like this or something. What is this the proper way that it should be applied? What is this going to accomplish?
Yes, this is a proven powder, mystical powder. And a good friend of mine, his name is Sasquatch Sam, he came up with this powder, and I met him at the UFO conference a couple years ago, and he has documented all the footprints from the spirits that could not leave the house.
So this will pick up the footprints of a spirit, whereas a normal powder of some kind would not leave a footprint, but they would leave a footprint in something like this?
This is a ghost trap. Powder.
Okay.
It is called the Ghost Trap Powder, specifically for your purpose, to send these ghosts back to the light, so they can rest in peace. They want to rest in peace too. It's tiresome for them to harass you.
But you said it's going to trap them. If it traps them, won't they be stuck in the house?
Why are you asking so many questions?
Because I want to know how to use this. If we can't use it properly, then
you
what's the
point?
You want
to use the baby powder that's all
it's,
over my
it's
dining room floor?
Ghost trap powder.
It's ghost trap powder?
They can look similar.
Can I marry a man that really believes in ghost trap powder?
Apparently, yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Continue on, Moth.
Yes. And so here we go. You want to kind of... brush it in between
it
your
out,
fingers.
Yeah, okay.
Stop
your
here.
Energy.
Stop right there.
You want to get your
energy
right on
here.
It?
Why does she have to stop? You're
going
to get
it's enough
vicinity, a bigger
right?
trap.
That's
a bigger
enough.
Trap.
That's
better
enough
chance
for
of catching
her.
Something. You know, I think that possibly the spirit is actually in some way partly possessing my wife, I think, to a certain extent. And I think that that's one of the reasons that, you know, in recent times she's been a little more agitatable. I don't know if that's a word. Just kind of easily set up, more short-tempered. I think that the spirit is causing that. I think, you know, the spirit inside of her is disrupting her energy or her aura.
Yeah, I notice these spirits visit the house very often.
Yeah.
All right, so apparently the ghost trap powder has been successful with some traps here. Danielle!
Yeah?
Come here. It worked.
I mean, there's tracks
Boy.
Here.
There's, oh my god, there is.
I don't get it that they look like sneakers, but I guess, I mean,
no,
ghost
no,
sneakers,
no.
Spirit sneakers, spirit shoes, I don't.
They're not sneakers, Micah, at all.
Spirit sneakers.
They have ghost slippers.
Ghost, okay.
They're totally ghost slippers, look at that.
Yeah.
That's spaced out, sneakers aren't spaced out like that. That is freaking me out, Micah.
Yeah.
Did you walk on it and not know? Because you could do that.
No, no.
Slow.
No. Well, no, I went around it. I went around it when I was getting the camera.
Wow. Baby, that's freaking me out.
Yeah,
I'm
so ghosts with sneakers.
I'm really
that's,
scared. Yeah. No, ghost slippers, baby. I read about it.
Really?
Yeah. Because they wear them, and this is exactly what the picture looked like. It's definitely a ghost slipper.
Okay, I don't know what we're supposed
yeah.
to do now with the powder. Do we just, like, clean it up and, like, throw it away? Or
yes,
do we have to,
definitely.
Like, get Butterfly back? Or maybe we get Butterfly back over here. She would do something with it.
I would definitely clean it up, throw it away, and forget about it. It's scary.
Okay, then maybe they're gone now.
Yeah.
Or, you know, maybe.
That's scary.
All right.
Did you have the camera rolling all night on this?
Not right here, unfortunately.
Good, Well, you know, not good, because then we could catch
Yeah, we could have caught them. That would have been... Oh, well.
Damn, You have to think about these things.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Micah.
I know.
Come on now, think.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. This whole experiment.
All right, so we should clean it up then.
Yeah, definitely.
All right.
Room's underneath the sink, okay, honey?
Okay, I'll go get it.
Thanks, babe.
Now explain to me that butterfly, you and your wife, and I have the tape. And it was viewing it, and noticed you had a Ouija board.
Yeah, I had thought that those were kind of a toy, but according to Butterfly, they can be used for legitimate paranormal purposes. So we incorporated one of those into our investigation.
And this Ouija board, all of a sudden, you got in an argument with your wife, and the Ouija board, for some reason, out of nowhere, just lit up on fire.
I think that what that was is that we had been trying to communicate with the spirit via the Ouija board, and then, like you said, my wife and I got into an argument, and I think that the spirit became angry that we were no longer focusing on the spirit and was trying to get our attention and saying, hey, you know, let's communicate, and I think it sent a pretty strong message.
Okay, we are out on the patio with Butterfly and the Ouija board. Hopefully... And Danielle, of course. What are we doing here? What's the goal? How does this work?
Our divine Ouija is giving us answers here. That okay. I am asking about the foot ghost prints.
Okay.
The ghost trap.
The ones in the ghost trap powder.
The bait.
In some kind of sandals. Ghost sandals. What did we think they might be?
Ghost sandals.
No, okay.
Ghost slippers.
And yes.
What is it saying about the ghost slippers?
The answer is, well, let's ask Danielle. Danielle can validate here our Ouija. Danielle, tell us about the footprints. Whether they were male or female.
What does that have to do with anything?
I don't know. That's a good question. Did they see male or female?
They were pretty big.
I'm guessing they were.
It's really.
But no, I mean, they're pretty big. I mean, if it were male or female, it would have probably been.
No. That's a stupid question. I tend to think it's a female because it has a lot of characteristics that I have.
Mm-hmm.
Could be very bitchy and crabby at times. Other times, it could just do things, go on a whim for no explanation at all, as the slamming of the door. My husband didn't do anything wrong. He was coming into the bedroom, and the door just slammed. Kind of like a female, we do things sometimes without any explanation. Okay, so let's say it's a female. Next.
Well, no, but not let's say. Let's try to figure it out. I mean, if they were larger, I think.
Well, sizes are distorted when you go to the afterlife.
Danielle, that's a stupid question.
Please, Danielle, you're doing evil in my backyard right now, Micah.
She's possessed, Micah.
I'm not possessed. She's not telling the truth. Watch your tongue when you talk to me.
She is in trouble.
Seriously, I'm not in trouble with anything. I don't want to argue
in front of you in there.
What? It's my house. I can't
argue
with you.
I understand that, but I feel like we are going to interrupt the process.
What process?
If we are arguing, then that's going to... The spirit
Micah,
waves.
You found her in the freaking yellow pages, okay? How real do you think she really is?
She seems pretty legit to me.
Really?
I don't know.
Have you seen her? Are you blind? Do you see what I see?
What are you doing?
She's freaky.
That's,
okay?
That's the uniform type
yes,
clothing
it's a uniform
for
an actor who takes our money.
No, she's a spiritual
you
guy.
How spiritual do you think she is?
Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
Do you smoke?
No, I don't.
Does your wife smoke?
I don't believe so, no.
Do you believe Butterfly smokes?
I don't think that she would. I don't know. We didn't spend a lot of time together, but it doesn't seem... She seemed very pure. Very,
pure.
Spiritual. I want to say organic. I bet she shops at Whole Foods.
I bet she does.
Yeah.
What?
Stupid?
Why?
Because you are stupid right now. She's asking stupid questions that I do not want to answer. They're irrelevant to what's going on right now. Okay. I want to buy that house.
Oh my god!
Crazy, okay?
You guys, get over here right now! Right
what
now!
The
look
what
the
happened?
I told you are possessed! They have
me?
Taken over!
Look at what happened to the board!
You.
How you, that ha- I'm telling you, the ghosts, you are possessed by them, okay, Danielle?
I am not possessed by anybody,
you,
okay,
you have the evidence, okay, you know, all right?
What happened?
You know. You,
it lit on fire.
Yeah,
it's a bad energy.
On fire?
It's a bad energy.
What is
this
an omen,
energy?
Okay? So
what does this mean?
That means
evil
that
shit right
next,
there, Mika.
This is a whisper. And guess what? It's going to be a shout because your house is going to go down. And you might be burned up with it.
What?
Are you serious?
It can
me?
Burn you
That's
down.
Not funny. That's
Excuse
not funny.
Me?
That's not funny.
Watch
no,
out.
No,
I'm out
of my
do you
house.
See me
seriously?
Laughing?
This
is
I'm
bullshit,
not laughing.
Mika. I want this,
this,
I want this
I don't,
the, and this out of my house.
That,
out of my house.
Is,
a Ouija board. Just by the fire in our backyard, Mika. Out.
Yeah.
Get out.
No idea.
Get out.
No idea.
Get
what
out.
I'm seeing on the inner plane.
Mika, let's go right now. Get out of my house. Now.
Strange things that just keep being brought up and going on between you and your wife and and Butterfly. You're paying Butterfly, of course, to come in and try to figure out all these spirits, right?
Well, I mean, she is a professional. I mean, this is her job, so it would make sense that we would pay her to come in and try to, you know, do this service of, like I said, you know, getting the spirits out.
I gotta go. I gotta leave,
we,
okay?
Can we reconsider? Can we keep trying?
No.
Can we just take a break?
No.
Dear ones, my time has expired. I've been divinely downloaded with information from your spirit team, from my spirit guides, and Archangel Michael, Raphael, Jeremiah, Jophiel, and Raffi, and they want me to go. They want me to go now, so,
but
you know.
But we can't, like, we, can we just, they could be wrong. They may be the wrong this time, and you need to stay and keep trying.
Are you demented too?
No, I just,
I
think
got,
she,
I'm sorry,
just,
there's nothing you can say.
We just, we come back in the kitchen.
No,
we just,
you can
we
go.
Take a break.
She can actually
more,
let
more
herself
spirit
out.
Powder, more the spirit,
no.
Throw more spirit powder on her.
No.
Okay, okay, no, no, no more spirit powder.
Micah, get her out of the house.
No.
Don't touch me, you told her to throw powder on me. Get out of my house!
You can call the 1-900 Exorcist, and they can help you.
That's what we'll do.
Conduct and perform a
thing. Why can't you do the exorcism? You can do the exorcism.
I'm sorry, I do not do exorcisms, okay? I'm not permitted to do exorcisms in this life. That is not my life path, and that is your path to deal with, not mine.
Okay.
So I bless you, and bless your home. Good night.
Really?
Well, now she's gone.
Good.
No, that's not good.
Yes, it is good.
We were.
That was
we
the
were,
whole plan from the get-go.
Actually, gone.
Bye. You're psychotic.
She's psychic.
No. I said you're psychotic. That is just abnormal and weird. I want no part of that in my house.
She clearly was trying to help. I mean, I, you know.
Do you believe
there was
your
no
wife?
Guarantee of success.
Do you believe your wife?
Yeah, I mean, I don't think that she has any reason to lie.
I'd like for you to explain an incident that occurred about something at the night.
Yes, we...
What was that? There was something you didn't, you actually kind of left out of the
yeah,
camera
we,
there.
Sort of.
But I heard a door slam.
Oh, that one, yeah.
You know, somebody in the house maybe, or running around, or hiding?
I think that was the spirit slamming the door. Once again, possibly trying to get our attention for some reason, possibly trying to scare us, whatever it was. But I haven't watched the footage for that part exactly, so I don't know if maybe you can get a glimpse of the spirit, maybe some movement of some kind. There was nobody else in the house, it was just me, Danielle. I had just gotten home a little bit before that.
Yes! Oh, what's your name? What is
Dante.
Your name?
Dante!
Woo! Dante! Oh, get
over
here.
Do you like that, Mommy?
Slap me,
like
Sammy.
That, Mommy?
Bark like a dog. Meow!
What happened? Did something happen?
Buddy!
Oh my god!
Oh my god.
We gotta
Is this on? Oh, perfect. Good. We got this. Okay, awesome. We got this on tape. We got this documented. What happened? What? Tell me what happened. Tell me what happened. Tell me what happened.
This is the spirits, baby.
The spirits attacked you.
Oh, it was the spirits. They came out of nowhere.
They're getting pissed off.
They're getting so aggravated.
Are you okay?
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. My heart is beating a mile a minute. You have this on film, honey? Or did
you just put this on right now? This is going to be perfect. No, we have this on film. We have this. Okay, this is good. Huge. This is proof.
Because that was serious. That was intense. That was intense.
I mean, you look like they really got after you here.
Honey, they just totally just tried to take over my entire body and take over everything.
I'm so sorry. I wasn't here to help you. I'm so sorry.
Okay, this is what you need to do, okay? Okay.
What do you need? Anything you need? What do you need?
Go get me, like, water right now in the kitchen. Leave the camera and go get me some water because, I just gotta relax a little bit. 2 minutes. Give me 2 minutes. Actually, can you brew some herbal tea for me? It'll really calm me down.
Yes. Herbal tea. Right away.
Woo! All right, thank you.
Herbal tea. Go
okay,
on.
Just
go
leave
on.
That
go
camera.
On. Yep.
Okay.
Yep. Herbal tea. Got
Thanks.
It. Got it.
Thanks, hon.
No problem. Herbal tea. Come right up.
Danielle, what is really going on in your house?
Doc, that's why we have come to you to tell us that.
Yeah.
It's pretty simple. I live a very happy, loyal life with my husband, and crazy spiritual things have been happening.
All right, so we have set up a camera to watch us in the bedroom, see if anything's going on, paranormal, any supernatural type stuff while we're sleeping. Hopefully nothing.
Hopefully
safe and sound for the night.
Yeah.
But like to have it on tape if anything does happen. Is that it? Is that all? Anything else?
Yeah.
No? All right. Bedtime.
Good night. I have so many things I have to do tomorrow.
We can talk about it tomorrow. I'm going to bed.
Oh, okay. Good night, Cookie.
Good night, baby. See you in the morning. What was that?
Oh, I don't know.
What? That door was open.
Look at the closet.
That door was closed.
That door was definitely closed.
The spirits are really in our house? They are moving stuff. They can move. If they can move, that is not good. If they have a physical presence.
That's scary.
I gotta go check it out.
No, don't go check it out. Please don't go check it out, because if they're violent, then they can hurt you.
They're not. They were just here. They didn't do anything violent.
Don't go outside. Please don't go outside.
I'll be right back.
No. I don't think you should go inside. Outside. At all. Because they can do something bad to you.
I don't.
They can eat your flesh and do whatever demonic crap that these people do.
I don't think they're going to eat my flesh.
No. Please don't go out. Please just stay near me.
Okay. I'll check it out
nothing,
in the morning.
There's nothing to look at anymore, okay? Please just go to sleep. Oh, that was really freaky. Please.
We got it on tape, so we'll figure it out in the morning.
Yep. Okay, figure it out in the morning.
Figure it out in the morning?
Mm-hmm.
Alright.
Good night.
You can call them paranormal activity, Micah. You can call it maybe normal activity going on in your home, Micah. But my investigators and myself have concluded with our investigation between your wife and Butterfly. Your wife is a very beautiful woman.
Thank you.
Micah.
I know. How is that relevant?
You figure it out. I've noticed with some of the things that have been going on between you and your wife, I noticed you get into a lot of arguments with all these paranormal activity that's been going on.
What couple doesn't, have their spats once and again?
I want to leave right now!
But no, that doesn't solve anything.
Yes, it does. I don't care what it
solves. No, they'll follow us. They'll follow us to the next house, the next house, or the next apartment, or wherever.
They live everywhere, Micah. This is the only house that it's happened in.
Well, I think it's... No, but it's
got to be... I don't care what you think. I don't give a shit what you think. We are leaving this house right now.
I don't know. No, you're upset. You're upset.
I'm not upset. I'm perfectly normal right now.
No, you're upset. We'll talk about this later. We can talk about this later.
Oh, Micah, don't you turn your back on me. See what you make me do, honey? I hit you. I hit you when you get crazy like that. Be calm. Be nice.
Why? Why? Just... Why do you have to be so mean all the time?
I cannot help it sometimes.
It's just the demon. That's why. You used to be so nice.
Honey.
You used to be so sweet.
Honey, that was before we were married. Honey, it is not a demon. It is you not doing what I am asking of you.
We can't leave. Why? We can't leave. It won't solve anything.
Yes, we can. Get up, get my bags, because they are packed and ready to go. And let's leave.
No.
Oh, yes. Don't you know me?
I will get up, but we are not leaving.
In 5 seconds.
We're not leaving.
Yes, we are. Oh, I will give you a fresh one. Don't you dare talk back to me.
Like any married couple, you know, we have fights here and there, but I like to spice it up every now and again. But he's very, he's a laid-back guy. He's a sweet guy.
You know, I'm just curious about when the power went out. Did you guys realize that maybe pay the bill?
He pays the bill every month.
So maybe him forgetting to pay the bill? Why would he forget to pay the bill?
I don't know. Is that my house? Is that my bill?
That is your bill.
I don't know.
You know, my investigators have pictures as well of when the Ouija board catching on fire. Do you smoke?
No. No.
Does your husband smoke?
No, definitely. No.
Does butterfly smoke?
No.
Then why were cigarettes found throughout your house, in and out? My investigators were speaking with your neighbors of strange things that possibly could they see or heard or smell happening as a neighbor, and told us, no, the only thing we do is barbecue on the weekends. Can you explain that?
No, it was the smell of the fire pits of hell.
With all this evidence I've shown you from some of my investigators, are you in shock? Bill didn't get paid? So did the power really go out because of ghost, or did the power go out because the bill wasn't paid? Did the smells of a barbecue coming in wasn't really smells of spirits? The Ouija board didn't catch on fire. It was caught on fire by someone smoking.
These are all, you're giving me scientific answers to an unknown situation.
I mean, a scientist. I am a doctor.
Right.
And my job
is to find the truth, not a logical explanation.
I mean, if it's not paranormal activity, if it's not, I mean, then what would explain the picture and...
Yes, the pictures and the ghost and the spirits.
And the moving of it. So then if the footprints weren't the spirits, footprints, and they were...
It's pretty much an overview,
I mean,
think of...
There's probably some other explanation here. I mean, it's not cut and dry, I think, what's going on. I think that it makes sense that, fuck.
Micah, we have real big issues here, too, to be exact. One, they stole my black skinny jeans out of my bedroom, and they know how much I love my black skinny jeans, and that's why they took it, because they're trying to mess with me. They're trying to bring me down. Two, honey, they stole the baby sex toys, okay? They know that's the only reason why this relationship is as good as it is. They're messing with us now, Micah. They're messing with us. They took two crucial things out of my life, and this has got to stop. I've had enough. Whoever is in this house, you need to exorcise them out. Seriously, hiring Butterfly wasn't cutting it for me. You need to do something better. You need to get a bat and go and physically hit each one of them. Do you understand me, Micah? I know, you do. Say yes. Micah, I'm talking to you. Micah, I'm talking to you. When I talk to you, I expect you to talk to me back. There are issues here that may ruin our relationship, our marriage. You know how much I love them, Micah, and this is an issue. I love them both equally. They both mean a lot to my life, especially the second one I mentioned. It's really the only thing that keeps this marriage together. However, get up, Micah, we need to talk about this, because this is serious, this is my house, and I will be the only one telling me what I can or cannot have. Does everybody hear me? If you hear me, listen to me. I'm a crazy bitch. I will take you down. I will take you all down. Micah, get up! Micah, I'm talking to you. Honey. Honey, I'm talking to you. Micah, you're supposed to talk back to me right now. Micah, why aren't you answering me back right now? This is rude of you to be doing this to me. You know what happens when I get mad, honey. Freak out, Micah. Wake up. Wake up, Micah, 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 Micah. Wake up, Micah! Honey. Honey, it's not nice that you're doing this to me right now, Micah. Wake up! Move your chest. Why isn't it moving? Micah, your heart's not beating. Micah, why isn't your heart beating right now? Wake up. Micah, are you not me? Micah! You're dead. Micah, you're not dead. Micah, wake up! Oh my God, I don't want anybody to die in my house. Micah, wake up. Honey, if you're dead, I will be freaked out for the rest of my life and I will have to put this house up on the market. Seriously, please don't be dead. Wake up. Wake up. Oh my God, my husband's dead. Oh my God, my husband's dead. In my house. My husband's dead in my house. Who are you and what are you doing? Get out of my house. What did that freak do? What did that freak say? Spiritual, spiritual. What do I need to be spiritual? Somebody, what is this? Put it on your face. It takes the evil spirits away. Huh. Really? Really? Is this really? Is this what I have to be doing right now? Seriously? Oh my God, it's on my foundation. Hail Mary, Mother full of Lord. I did not do anything that bad. I swear it was only sad. That's it. I won't do it anymore. Just make my husband wake up. I'll be good, I promise. Maybe twice a year. Please, I don't deserve this. I can't handle a dead person in my house. Okay, all right. I don't know, what else does she do? Pray like a, I don't know. Dear Lord, please take him out of my house. Get out of my house. Look at me, okay? I'm demon full bulletproof. Don't get me, don't attack me. I'm gonna leave. And when I come back, you're all gonna be gone. I will knuckle you up. You understand me? Micah, I want to say it one more time. Micah, get up. Micah, really get up this time, please, honey. I don't want to be a bad wife and leave you in the house, but I so will. 5 seconds, ready, Micah? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, for you. Oh, I love you. What are you going to do?
Children could see, but I can't find them for the life of me. And there's Halloween spooks outside my window.